your cell phones. This performance will feature music professor Orlando Sella conducting members of the new Lowell Chamber Orchestra. They will be joined by three. Also notable, they'll be joined by three MCC student actors. Woo! But now, I would like to make a toast to Igor.
To Igor!
Don't forget. Toast to Joe.
Toast to Joe, then!
Excuse me?
You serious?
I'm sorry, who said that?
You really gonna do that to us, really? You came to see a show, and you don't know. You don't know who it's about.
Down a hot and dusty road, tramps a soldier on his load.
Thank you.
me a fit.
No.
Sell it to me.
No.
All right. I'll give you this book for it, then.
Can't read?
Makes no difference. There's no need. With this book, you don't have to read. But it's more than a book. It's well foretold. You've only to open it. Lo and behold, banknotes, bearer bonds, and gold.
Well, I should want to have a look.
Certainly, certainly. There's the book.
On sight, collateral, note of hand. This book's not easy to understand.
I can read it all right, but it's still Greek to me.
You'll get the hang of it. Wait and see.
But look, sir, if it's worth all that money, this little job, that old fiddle of mine you want only costs a few bob.
So you've a real bargain.
It's a deal.
On sight, collateral, note of hand, market quotations for Tuesday the 31st? What day is it today? It's a Friday. Why, it's Friday the 13th. What's this? Here's a book that's ahead of the date. A strange sort of book. It tells you things before they happen.
Come home with me. Now what do you say?
What? What's up?
This thing won't play. You must teach me to make it go.
I've only 10 days leave, you know.
I shall lend you my carriage and pair. If you walk, you'll be much more slow.
Mother will worry if I'm late.
Isn't the first time she's had to wait?
And my girlfriend expects me to.
You'll make it up to her soon. She'll be all the more pleased when you do.
Now, this place of yours, is it abroad?
Wine, dine, full bed and board. Home in a carriage like the Lord. 2 or 3 days, a step out of your way, and then you'll be rich as the king of Cathay.
What sort of victuals down your way?
Steak, egg, and chips.
3 times a day.
And to drink?
Champagne rosé.
And smoking permitted?
Ah! What do you say? To Havana cigars, now what do you say?
There you are, then. That's the way. That's how you want it. That's the trick. Joseph goes off home with old Nick, and he finds that the old boy doesn't cheat. New clothes, soft beds, and plenty to eat. Yes, Joseph is properly done up a treat. And each shows the other as they undertook the way of the fiddle and the way of the book. Yes, the old fellow kept his word. 2 days well spent, and then came the third. That morning, the old man wakes Joseph as soon as it's light, and he says, "Are you ready?" And Joseph says, "Right." "Did you have a good night?" And Joseph says, "Yes." And the devil looks on as he gets up to dress. "Have you any complaints?" And Joseph says, "No." "Right you are," says old Nick. "Then off we go." They get in the carriage, waiting below. And the devil says, "Hup!" and off they go. Only Joseph, watching the horse's flying feet, finds himself holding on with both hands to his seat with all his might, till his knuckles are white. "Hold tight," cries the little old man. "Hold on tight." Joseph would like to get up and jump out, but he hasn't a chance. "Take care," cries the devil. "See how my horses prance. They'll lead us a dance. They're taking the air. Take care." And the carriage is suddenly traveling up in the air, hurtling, rattling, rolling round the sky. And Joseph's hair stands on end, and he nearly faints. "Have you any complaints? Have you any complaints?" Higher and higher, over valley and hill, faster and faster, up and up they soar. Till time stands still. Then everything is as it was before.
Mm-hmm.
dusty road, tramps a soldier with his bow. Another slams, and more, and the rusty hinges shriek as every door slams shut. That's funny, he thinks, but mother will know. I'd better go. But she sees him coming. She screams and runs away. So then, he thinks, there's my fiance. Married? With two children?
What?
Hey, the dirty cheat, the dirty rotten, oh, and I know who you are at last. I know what's happened. I know you. I've taken my time about it too. It wasn't 3 days, 3 years had passed. They all take me for a ghost. I'm dead, I'm on the living. Oh, the cheat, the dirty rotten, and like a fool, I went and listened to him. Yes, I know I was tired and hungry, but that's no reason to go listening to the likes of him. Do you take any notice of what people you don't know tell you? No, you say, I don't know you. But what do? I listened to him. I should have had my suspicions. But no, I listened to him. Like a fool, I had to go and listen to him. And I gave him my fiddle. Of all the luck. Then what am I going to do now? What am I going to do now? What am I going to do now?
Dirty cheat, it's you.
Now what are you going to do?
You dirty, rotten cheat.
Please, be a little more discreet. Do try and behave, do you hear me? Good. Now what are you going to do? Have you forgotten all I said? The book I gave you bound in red?
It's somewhere in my kit.
Then you got all you need if you've still got it. And aren't you a soldier? Be one then! Show the ladies and gentlemen! On guard! Attention! That's it! Put that up! Break ranks and stow your kit! There we are! Platoon! Fall in! At the run! At ease! Stand easy! Attention! Platoon! Off caps! Take this one of mine. Not bad. Suits you fine. Now then, take off your tunic, unbutton the throat. Do not fall out. We'll find you a coat. This'll do. Come on, don't fall out. We've hardly begun. You're not finished yet. Attention! The book! Oh no, what have you done? Oh, yes, you told me. Well, fetch it then. No. Only the book.
careful. Don't let it come to harm. You'll lose it like that. Put it under your arm. This book is worth a fortune. A fortune, do you see? Hold on to it tight. And listen to me. This is mine here, and that is yours there. To each his own, and so, all square.
Everybody has but you, that you have no more, the only things worth having. Just to stretch out on the grass as you used to do, good to touch, good to feel, things that cost nothing, that everyone has, that mean so much. These things are real, things that belong to all the world but you. Saturday evening, so many people with watering cans. The little girls playing Tom Tiddler's ground. You smile as you pass along to some big ball. You settle down on the grass and someone fills your glass. Things that are warm inside. The only ones worth having. They have nothing, and yet they have it all. And I, who have everything, I have nothing.
Nothing. Nothing. How can that be? Satan. Satan, you've cheated me. Oh, what can I do? It does it say in the book? He snatches it up and starts to look. You must know. You must know. Tell me how everyone, how all the others are happy. How is it done? You must know. You must know. You must tell me, explain what I can do to have nothing again. The telephone rings.
Hello? Sir, with regard to your current account, sir.
Later.
The telephone rings.
Later, I tell you, later. The book must know the secret. Then answer me. What can I do to be as I used to be?
I've been proud and envied. And in my pride, I am dead inside, to the world outside. I am rich, unbelievably rich. But all I'd give to be alive again, as others live, I am the dead among the living.
Please, kind sir. Kindly.
What is it?
A few words with you, sir. But before I begin, you seem to have dropped something, sir. You might miss.
What is it?
I'll explain, sir. It's this. I've a little case outside full of rare and precious things, sir. Well, I've been glad.
No, thank you.
Sir, for pity's sake.
Take this.
Sir, we have a prize. Nothing for nothing is the rule. Each has his little job to do. Would you please let me go and bring it into you? Look at these wonderful things. Watches, necklaces, and rings. Some lace, sir? No? Don't be afraid to say so. A lucky medallion engraved on the back?
No.
No? Oh, what do you lack? A mirror, perhaps? No? Oh, what a shame. Beautiful picture, complete with a frame. Oh, that seems to arouse your interest. No? Still no? Oh, same as the rest.
How much, I said?
Well, as we're friends, I won't stand in the way. Try it first, see what you say. I'll fix a price. Let's hear you play.
Thank you.
planning? No one knows. He doesn't know himself. He only knows he must get out, go somewhere else, because he can't go on the way he was. Nothing remains of all his fine belongings. He's thrown them out. Without a word to say to anyone, he's run away. And things are just the way they were. Except, of course, he has no pack to bear. Is he taking the homeward road? The road he took before? Home? No. It's not his anymore. The leaves stir in the wind. But what's this? Suddenly the world outside comes crashing in again. Somebody starts to beat a drum. And someone beats a drum because the princess of the realm, the only daughter of the king, lies ill in bed. She neither sleeps, nor speaks, nor eats, nor anything. And the king proclaims to the sound of the drum, that whatsoever man shall come and raise his daughter from her bed, that man, the fair princess, shall wed. Just at that moment, a man comes up and says to Joseph, "Hello, chum. We've not been introduced, it's true. But, well, I've been a soldier too. Old comrades, don't mind if you make yourself known. When I saw you come in and you were alone, I said to myself, have a word with him. He looks a bit down, I said. You can see at a glance. Go on over. Who knows? This may be his big chance. A lovely young girl. What about it? A princess, too. Think of that. I'd say it was made for you. I'm married already. Worse luck. It's no use to me. You, my lad, you're young, you're free. Doctoring? Well, that's whatever you choose. Besides, you know, you've nothing to lose by trying. You go, you say, I'm an MO. She's cured, she's not. It's worth a shot. Why not? After all, why not? Goodbye, old chap. Thanks for the tip. He's up, he's out of it quick as a whip. He's up, he's off, he makes his way to the palace gates. He gives a ring. Where are you going, the sentry say?
Where am I going? To see the king!
Thank you.
gave the word for the king, for the pant plague, excuse me. The king received me, the king no less. He said to me, you are a doctor? I said, an army doctor, yes. Many have come, you know, but none have stayed. Oh, I have my methods. I'm not dismayed. Very well. Tomorrow you see the princess. It went off just as we thought it would. That fellow was right. So far, so good. Just think, a girl to call your own after so many years alone.
Why not? Why shouldn't the luck be mine? Go ahead, ask the cards. What do you say? Six of hearts? Ten of hearts? Queen of hearts? Nothing but hearts trumps all the way. It's true, why not? Why shouldn't it be? I have a wife of my own, only for me. And what more, princess, too?
Someone's here ahead of you. You were silly to be upset. You were rich and esteemed, you get. A sudden whim, don't count the cost. And now, my poor young friend, you're lost. Oh, six of hearts, ten of hearts, hearts all the way. You said to myself, oh, it's my lucky day. Well, do you still believe that's true? I have my methods. I, not you.
It's true what he says. He's got me for sure. He'll do the trick. He's got the cure. I have nothing. Nothing at all once more.
Go for him just the same. Knock him down. Bang his head on the floor.
He's a man. He can do nothing more.
But you can. I tell you, you can. He's got you. Because of the money. You still have money of his. Get rid of that, and you're saved. Go on, begin. Offer to play him at cards. He's sure to win.
Will you play? I have money.
What? I don't understand.
I said, would you like a game?
Oh, my dear young friend. I'm always ready for a hand.
He'll win. He always likes to win. You'll lose, and he will be lost. Begin.
Notes, gold, silver, they're all in.
Good.
Now, how much a point?
A buck, yes.
Sixpence a point, not a penny less.
Oh, just as you wish, but let's take care.
Go fish?
Oh, yeah.
I got five. Five blues. Good.
Yeah. No more fiddle. No more book. Three. Only a few pennies left. And look. Oh, the pennies are flying into the air. Then where will you be? Total defeat. You'll go around naked, no shoes to your feet.
Raise him a buck.
A buck?
What? You're mad.
10 smackaroos, deal on.
I stake the lot.
Ace of spades.
Queen of Hearts.
You see, he's going to fall. Now, get up, here's what you do. Give him a drink. Say, here's a health to you. It'll do him good.
Here, take this. It'll do you good. Go on. Have a drink. Say when.
When?
Okay. Here's a health to you. Again.
Thank you.
I can still see you.
to wait. But this ram of yours is not so great. If once its fretches should be passed, then you'll be in my power at last. So do not push your luck too far, or then, my princess, you will find that you are back in bed again. As for your prince, he can't pretend he doesn't know my patience. Now is at an end. He who loves the last, he loves most. As I shall do to one, he loves.
She looks at him and smiles and says, "You want to. I can see you do. It isn't much to ask of you. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Why not? You want to. I can see you do." He says, "Come over here to me. Not until you say yes." And so he thinks, "If we did go, perhaps this time my mother will know me. Why not? Just to pay a call, and she could come and live with us. Then I should really have it all." They're on their way. They're nearly there. A scent, he knows, hangs in the air. He has gone on ahead to find the frontier. She is a little way behind. He calls her. He turns back, then changes his mind.